Chapter 16 of the Book of Jubilees. And on the new moon of the fourth month, we, the angels, appeared unto Abraham at the oak of Mamre. And we talked with him, and we announced to him that a son would be given unto him by Sarah his wife. And Sarah laughed, for she heard that we had spoke these words with Abraham. And we admonished her, and she became afraid, and denied that she had laughed on the account of the words. And we told her the name of her son, as his name is ordained and written in the heavenly tablets, as Isaac, that when we returned to her at a set of times, she would have conceived a son. And in this month Yahweh executed this judgment on Sodom and Gomorrah and Zeblon and all the regions of Jordan. And he burned them with fire and brimstone and destroyed them unto this day. Even as lo, I have declared unto thee all their works, that they were wicked and sinners exceedingly, and they defiled themselves and committed fornication with their flesh, and work uncleanness on the earth. And like manner God will execute judgment on the palaces where they have done according to uncleanness of the Sodomites, like unto the judgment of Sodom. But Lot we saved, for God's remembered Abraham, and sent him out from amidst the overthrow. And he and his daughters committed sin upon the earth, such as not been on the earth since the days of Adam till his time. And the men lay with his daughters. And behold, it was commanded and engraven concerning all his seed and the heavenly tablets, and removed them and root them out, to execute judgment upon them like the judgment of Sodom, and to leave no seed of the man upon the earth on the day of condemnation. And in this month Abraham moved from Hebron and departed, and dwelt between Kadesh and Sur in the mountains of Gior. In the middle of the fifth month he moved from hence, and dwelt in the well of the oath. And in the middle of the sixth month Yahweh visited Sarah, and did unto her as he had spoken, and she conceived. And she bore a son in the third month, in the middle of the month, and at that time which Yahweh had spoke to Abraham on the festival of the first fruits of the harvest, Isaac was born. And Abraham circumcised his son on the eighth day, and he was the first that was circumcised according to the covenant, which is ordained forever. And in the sixth year of the fourth week he came to Abraham at the well of the oath, and he appeared to him, as he had told Sarah, that we, the angels, would return to her, and she would have conceived a son. And we returned in the seventh month, and found Sarah with child before us, and we blessed him. And we announced to him all the things which had been decreed according to him, that he should not die until he should beget six sons more, and would see them before he would die, but that Isaac should be his name and seed be called, and that all the seed of his sons should be Gentiles and be reckoned with the Gentiles, but from the sons of Isaac one should be holy seed, and should not be reckoned among the Gentiles, for he should become the portion of the Most High, and all his seed had fallen into the possession of God, and it should be unto Yahweh a people for his possession above all the nations, and that it should be become a kingdom of the priest and the holy nation. And we went our way, and we announced to Sarah all that we had been told him, and they both rejoiced in exceedingly great joy. And we built there an altar to Yahweh, who had delivered him, and who was making him rejoice in the land of his sojourning, and celebrated a festival of joy in this month 7 days near the altar, which he had built a well of the oath. And he built booths for himself and for his servants and for this festival, and he was the first to celebrate the Feast of the Tabernacles on the earth. And during these 7 months he brought each day to the altar a burnt offering to Yahweh, 2 oxen, 2 rams, 7 sheep, 1 he-goat, and a sin offering, that he might atone hereby for himself and for his seed. And as a thank offering, 7 rams, 7 kids, 7 sheep, 7 he-goats, and their fruit offering, and their drink offerings. And he burnt all the fat thereof on the altar, and chosen offering unto Yahweh a sweet-smelling savor. Morning and evening he burnt fragrant sacrifices, frankincense, galbum, sekhet, and nard, and myrrh, and spice, and custom, and all seven he offered, crushed, mixed together in equal parts, and pure. And he celebrated this feast during 7 days, rejoicing with all his heart, with all his soul, he and all those who were in his house, and there was no stranger with him, nor any that was uncircumcised. And he blessed his Creator, who had created him in his generation. For he had created him according to his good pleasure. For he knew and perceived that from him would arise a plant of righteousness for eternal generations, and from him a holy seed, so that it should become like him who had made all things. And he blessed and rejoiced, and he called the name of this festival the Festival of Yahweh, a joy acceptable to the Most High God. And he blessed him forever and all his seed after him throughout all the generations of the earth, because he celebrated this festival in its season according to the testimony of the heavenly tablets. For this reason it is ordained on the heavenly tablets concerning Israel that they should celebrate the Feast of Tabernacles 7 days with joy, and in the seventh month acceptable before Yahweh, a salute for ever throughout their generations every year. And to this there is no limit of days, for it is ordained that ever regarding Israel that they shall celebrate it and dwell in booths, and set wreaths upon their heads, and take lofty droves and willows from the brook. And Abraham took branches of palm trees and a fruit of goodly trees, and every day going around the altar with branches, seven times a day in the morning, he praised and gave thanks to his God for all things in joy.